Today, we're going to learn how to make custom transitions in Final Cut Pro. You don't need to buy and download any expensive plugins. You don't even need Motion. All you will need for this is an adjustment layer, which you can easily make yourself or download for free. If you need one, I'll leave a link in the video description to my website where you can download one at no charge. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and get started. First example we'll take a look at today is a simple spin transition. With the two clips you want to transition between in your timeline, open your Titles and Generators browser and locate your adjustment layer. Add this adjustment layer above your clips and ripple trim it to about 20 frames in length. Select the Transform tool and add a keyframe. Place your playhead between your two clips and, with the adjustment layer selected, change the Scale All value to 600% and change the rotation to 180 degrees. Move your playhead to the end of the adjustment layer, change the scale back to 100%, and set the rotation to 360 degrees. Set your playhead between your two clips again, open the effects browser, and select the blurs category. Add the radial blur effect to your adjustment layer, set the amount to about 50, and add a keyframe to your amount slider. Move your playhead to the start of the adjustment layer, and bring the amount down to zero. Move to the end of the adjustment layer and bring the amount down to zero again. Render out your timeline for this custom spin transition. The next example we'll take a look at today, I call it overexposure transition. Once again, add an adjustment layer above your clips, and this time make it about 1 second long. Move your playhead to the start, make sure the adjustment layer is selected. Head up to the Inspector window and select the Color Inspector. Add a Color Wheels correction and add a keyframe. Move your playhead between the two clips and adjust the exposure until your clip is barely visible. Move your playhead to the end of your adjustment layer and double-click any controls you adjusted to reset them. Just like before, adding some blur to your adjustment layers makes it look even better. Set your playhead in the middle of your adjustment layer, add the Gaussian blur effect, bring the amount all the way up, and add a keyframe to the amount slider. Go back to the start, and bring this back down to zero. Do the same at the end. Give your clip a few seconds to render out for this cool overexposure transition. Using the same method with certain video effects makes for even cooler transitions. We'll take a look at a couple examples, but before we do, let me tell you about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. If you're looking for more options for transitions, titles, or effects to use with Final Cut Pro, Envato Elements has you covered. A subscription to Envato Elements includes over 3,000 Apple Motion packs ready for use in your next project. But that's not all. You also get unlimited downloads of stock video, royalty-free music and sound effects, graphic templates, web templates, and much more. For one low monthly price, you get access to millions of digital assets, all covered by one simple license, so you never have to worry about copyright strikes. You can try it risk-free for 7 days, and if you don't love it, simply cancel your subscription and you won't be charged a single penny. Click the link in the video description and see how Envato Elements can help you make better videos. Now, back to Final Cut Pro. The first effect we'll use for a transition today is the comic look effect. Add an adjustment layer above your clips, and once again, ripple trim it to about 1 second long. From the effects browser, select the comic looks category and add the comic basic effect to your adjustment layer. Move your playhead to the start, bring the mix slider all the way down to zero, and add a keyframe. Move to the middle and bring the slider all the way up. Move to the end of your adjustment layer and bring the mix back down to zero. There's a couple more things we can do to make this transition look even better. First, I feel like this particular transition would benefit from being longer. Adjusting the length is fairly simple. Just ripple trim your adjustment layer out to make it longer, say about 3 seconds. Select the adjustment layer and press Ctrl V to bring up the video animation viewer. Grab the end keyframes and drag them out to the edges of your adjustment layer. Another thing we need to deal with is the hard cut between our two clips. To soften this cut, select the end handle of your first clip and press Command T to add the default cross dissolve transition. Here's the result. The last example we'll take a look at today will be a texture transition. Just like before, add an adjustment layer above your clips and make it about 3 seconds long. Head over to the effects browser, select the stylize category, and add the texture effect to your adjustment layer. Here, you can use a default wood texture, or if you want to, you can add your own texture clip to the drop zone in the inspector. With your playhead at the start, bring the amount slider down to 0 and add a keyframe. Move to the middle and bring the slider all the way up. Go to the end of your adjustment layer and bring the amount slider back down to 0. Add a cross dissolve transition between clips and render out your timeline for this cool texture transition. You can use this method basically with every effect in Final Cut Pro, giving you quite a few more transition options. Try it out and see what you can come up with. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.